Are you looking for a way to be more productive? Well, there's a free deal that's going on right now that's called menubarx. And what it does, it lets you open up browser tabs inside of the menu bar, which makes it pretty practical for certain type of tabs that you want to have open. Now, as of this video, you can grab the pro version for free. And the installation file is direct from the app store, so you can make sure that it's safe. Now, let me show you what I'm talking about and how to grab that free version right now. Okay, this is menubarx site, and I will leave the link in the description so you can go right ahead and jump into the Mac App Store to download it. Like I said, it's free and you can even grab the pro version for free. Now, what it's going to do, it's gonna install this on the top. You can see I have two tabs open right here. And if I click on it, I have it set to open up DuckDuckGo and it stays wherever I left it. So in this case, I have another tab for Instagram. I'm not logged in, but if I wanted to, I could have that logged in just in case it's practical for me. Now, let me start off by showing you how to grab the pro version. So once I open up one of these browser tabs inside of menubarx, I'm gonna head on over to the gear icon right here. Next, I'll go into preferences and I'm gonna go into the pro tab. Now, like I said, as of this video, I don't know in the future, but right now it's free. It's $0. To grab it now. All you have to do is click upgrade and sign in with your App Store account. And boom, you have the pro version for free. We have general settings just in case you want to launch this in a different way. So for example, launch at the beginning. So each time that you restart your computer, it's gonna open it up. Show website fav icon. So if you wanna have it like I do right now, I know that this is, that tab right there is for Instagram because I have the fav icon. The colorful fav icon, let me turn it off. It goes black and white just in case you don't want to see a lot of colors and you don't want to get distracted. In my case, I like to have it because it makes me find it easier for me, okay? And the start page, we have these options available. The default, the Google, DuckDuckGo, and Baidu. The web browser, open new tab, request in the browser, just in case you want to do that, and clear cache. In case you logged in and you want to log them out, you clear it, all right? Let me go back. And what it's gonna do is, once we open this, we have this browser bar, search bar, on the bottom. This is where we're going to enter our website. So for example, anything that you want to have ready here, you're gonna enter it here. We also have the back, forward, refresh, and the settings for this one. Let me go into Google, for example, google.com. There we go, I have that there. If I click away, I'm doing my other stuff, I'll jump into Google right there. If I want to have a quick search, there. Now, there's another option that I forgot to show you is that we have dimensions to show here. For example, right now we're viewing mobile phone. So in this case, we have the browser options for the window size. In this case, it's comparable to the iPhone SE, and that's the size that we're getting, such by such pixels, okay? If we want it larger, we have these options, desktop mini app, iPad mini, or desktop, in case you want to have it huge. In this case, I find it practical to have it this way, mobile view. In case you want to make it a little bit larger, well, we can choose that there in case that's practical for you, or just change the dimension to a bigger one. We also have options for the user agent. So right now we have iOS Safari or the desktop Mac apps, iOS. Auto refresh, right now it's disabled, but it could be, for example, let's just say I want to view the Bitcoin prices or the stock price for something. Well, I can have it refresh automatically with this amount of time, seconds or minutes. That way I always have the latest information once I go check it out. But in this case, it's a static page, so I'll leave it as disabled. And we have the hide toolbar if we like. So it's pretty useful depending on what you want to use it for, depending on what you want to have like quick access to it. Instead of using the traditional browser for this, you just want to have it really quickly there and jump to it. You see it's fast, it's easy to use, and we could choose search for anything. For example, software for CRM, I don't know. And boom, I'm already searching for it. Over here, I have to go open a new tab. In this case, I have to open Google because I don't have it that way, or I'll search right here. But it's just like I mentioned before, it's practical. If I have my Instagram logged in, which I don't right now, I can view the Instagram there and start surfing around if I like. And you can see that this didn't affect my size for the window because this one stayed how it is. So it's useful and it's practical that way. So it makes it more productive depending on the tabs you have there. Like I mentioned before, if you want to use it to view your stock, or we have options right here, for example, your Amazon store, your Spotify, these are just options right here, Google, YouTube, and these guys are just starting out. So as of now, they have a really good product and you can grab the pro version for free. And it just depends on you what you want to use it for. Just want to mention out there, this video is not sponsored. I didn't tell these guys I'm going to make the video. I just did it because I thought it's a great deal for you guys since it's free and you can grab the pro version right now. Well, I'll see you guys later. This is SaaS Master and bye-bye.